In this tutorial, we are going to be adding data to the project file. Click in the Task Name field of the first row and enter the name of the first layer summary task. Notice that the majority of the remaining columns get automatically filled with data. Ignore this information for now. Now enter the name of the first subtask that will need to be completed in the second row. This layer of subtask is often still generic in nature and acts as a second layer summary task. These are broken down into more detailed subtasks. Select the subtask that you just entered. Open the Task tab at the top of the window. Click the Indent Task icon. Notice that the first layer summary task has now been bolded. Enter the name of the next subtask. Remember that task names should be formatted as an action followed by the noun. Continue entering the task names and think about what level of subtask they should be. You should not go beyond 4 or 5 levels of depth. While you are entering these subtasks, you should also be thinking about what it is dependent on being completed before you begin working on it, and what will be dependent on it to be completed. Now that we have all the subtasks created for the first second layer summary task, let's start adding how long we think each task will take. Keep an eye on what happens to the date and duration fields of the other tasks, as well as how the timeline gets modified. Take the time to read any dialog boxes that pop up. They are usually giving you advice on how you may do things in a more efficient manner. When you are ready to add your next second layer summary task, you will need to outdent the task. Be sure to keep a close eye on the levels of your tasks. Notice that there are multiple ways of entering data for a task. You may simply double-click on any of the fields in a row and enter the desired information using the dialog box that opens. What happens if you need to add a task in the middle of your list? Simply right-click on the task below the row where you want to add the new task and click the Insert Task option. Once you have completed entering the subtasks, ask yourself which one will be the last one to be completed for this phase of the project. Look at the number beside the leftmost column. This will be the item number you will use for the dependency of the milestone. Remember that milestones must be identified by using an M colon in front of the noun followed by the action, and that the duration must be zero. The first subtask of the next phase of the project will most likely be dependent on the previous phase's milestone being complete. Finish entering all of the dependencies in the predecessors column. Remember to ask yourself if a task is truly dependent on another task being finished before it can be started. There are often times when multiple tasks can be worked on simultaneously. Now that all the durations and predecessors have been entered, have another look at how the summary tasks and timeline have changed.